Hello everyone, this is teacher Susie and welcome to my class. So we have here another word problem which is related to quadratic equations. So this can be found in the learning module week number 4, page number 4. So ipapaliwanag ko yung problem na nasa learning module so that the students in their homes will be able to understand the solutions on their learning modules. So let's start. Ang sabi dito, an office has 2 envelope stuffing machines. So meron dalawang stuffing machines yung office. So working together, they can stuff a batch of envelopes in 4 hours. Kapag sabay na ginamit yung envelope stuffing machines, so kaya nilang matapos yung work in 4 hours. So working separately, it will take the second machine, 6 hours longer than the first machine. So pag mag-isa lang, isa lang yung gagamitin, so yung second machine ay mas matagal ng 6 na oras compared to the first machine. Okay, to stuff a batch of envelopes. So how long would it take each machine to stuff a batch of envelopes by themselves? So kailangan natin malaman dito kung ilang oras or gaano katagal kayang mag-work ng bawat isa or ng machines if they work separately. Alright? So this is an example of work problem. So let us find the given. So ang sabi dito, working together, yung mga machines ay kayang gumawa ng trabaho in 4 hours. So 4 hours, so we will represent the work done. Okay, the 4 hours. Ito yung amount of time. So amount of time it takes by two machines working together. Or kayang magtrabaho ng dalawang machines, okay, in 4 hours. Pag pareho silang naka-andar or pareho silang ginamit. So working separately, so it will take the second machine 6 hours longer than the first. So hindi natin alam kung gaano katagal kayang magtrabaho ng first machine. So we will represent that with X because that is unknown, okay? So let X be the amount of time it takes the first machine, okay, the first machine to work alone, all right, and then so si second machine 6 hours longer than the first. So if the first machine is X and the second machine is 6 hours longer than the first, so the second machine will be represented as the first machine plus 6, the number of hours na kaya magtrabaho ng first machine, which is X, plus 6. So, mas matagal siya ng 6 hours. So, this will be the representation for the amount of time it takes the second machine to work alone. Okay? So, again, X, ito yung number of hours na kayang mag-work alone ng first machine. Okay, and then X plus 6, this is for the second machine. The amount of time na kaya magtrabaho ng second machine alone. So, the question is, how long would it take each machine to stuff a batch of envelopes by themselves? So, it means to say, kailangan natin malaman what is X and X plus 6. For us to be able na malaman kung gaano katagal nag-work alone ang machine number 1 and machine number 2. So, from the previous video na pinakita natin dito about work problem, we have or we use the formula 1 over A plus 1 over B equals 1 over X. Where A and B, ito yung work na kayang gawin. Okay, nang involved natin na persons or objects sa problem. And X is yung the work they can do together. So let's say A will represent the amount of time na kaya magtrabaho ng first machine. So that will be X. So this will be 1 over X. And then B, let's say this is the amount of time na kaya magtrabaho alone ng second machine. So that's X plus 6. So this will become 1 over X plus 6. So that is equal to 1 over, let's say X naman, yung amount of time it takes for two machines to work together, and that is 4. So we will write that as 1 over 4. So this is now our equation. We have a rational equation. Alright, so this rational equation, our aim is matanggal yung fraction niya. So what we are going to do is we will get, or we will look for the LCD. So we will take the denominators. So the denominators to get the LCD, so those are X. We will multiply them, X plus 6 and 4. So itong mga denominators natin, wala na silang other factors. Okay? Si 4 pwede pa 2 times 2, but still wala rin namang magbabago kasi wala naman siyang kaparehong factors dito sa X and X times X plus 6 rather. So, let's multiply X and 4. So this will become 4X na. X times 4 is 4X. And then si X plus 6, let's just copy it lang muna. Huwag mo muna natin i-multiply itong dalawa na ito. Alright? So, the LCD now is what we're going to multiply to the whole equation sa bawat term nitong ating equation. So, we are going to have here, so 1 over X times the LCD, or 1 times 4X times X plus 6. So, ito lang siya, diba? So, the numerator will become 4X times the quantity of X plus 6 over, we will copy denominator, X. So, again, 1, which is the numerator, times this is equal to this. That's why ito na siya. And then, we will copy all over X. And then, plus, okay, yung ating second term, 1 over X plus 6 times the LCD. So, 1 times the LCD. So, that's equal to the LCD, which is 4X times the quantity of X plus 6. And then, we will copy the denominator, X plus 6 equals. So, 1/4 times this, or 1 times the LCD. So, it's equal to the LCD again, 4X over the times the quantity of X plus 6 all over 4. Ngayon, let us cancel out yung mga pwedeng ma-cancel out. Let's start with the first term. We can cancel out X. So, wala na natira, which is 1 na lang. Okay, 1 na yan. So, 4 times 1 is 1. Distribute it to X plus 6. So, 4 times X is 4X. And then, 4 times 6, that is positive 24. Next, we can cancel out. Dito naman tayo sa second term natin. We can cancel out X plus 6. X plus 6. So, ang natira na lang ay 4X. So, plus 4X. Kasi 1 na lang to eh. Okay? So, that is equal to, here, we can cancel out 4. So, natira ang X and then this binomial. So, distribute X. X times X is X squared. X times 6 is 6X. Alright? So, let us now move all of these terms on the other side of the equal sign so that we can combine like terms. So, we can copy 4X plus 24 plus 4X. And then, X squared will become negative X squared. And then 6x will become negative 6x. And then equals, wala nang natira. So we will write 0. So combine like terms. And at the same time, let's write this in standard form. So quadratic equation na siya kung napapansin. So let's first write the ax squared. So dito natin isulat. So we have negative x squared followed by bx. So yung mga terms containing x, combine them. We have 4x plus 4x, that is 8x. 8x minus 6x. So, the answer is positive 2x. And then, the constant is 24. Wala na tayong term na constant, but 24 alone. So, we will just copy 24 and then equals 0. So this is now our quadratic equation written in standard form. And if you notice, our a is negative. So para maging positive ang a natin, so we will multiply the whole equation with negative 1. And multiplying the whole equation with negative 1, ibig sabihin ang bawat term ng equation natin ay magiging opposite its sign. So this will become, ito ay magiging positive na. This will become negative, and then this will become negative, then equals 0. So this is now our new quadratic equation. So we will solve this using any of the methods maliban sa extracting the square root. Alright? So let's use factoring. So let's prepare two parentheses equals 0. Factor x squared, those are x and x. And then let's think of the factors of negative 24 kung saan pag inad natin will give us negative 2. And those are negative 6 and positive 4. Because negative 6 times 4 is negative 24. Negative 6 plus 4 is negative 2. So these are the factors that we are looking for. Now let's write these factors as equation. So applying the zero product property. So this will become x minus 6 equals 0 for the first factor. And then we're going to have x plus 4 equals 0 for the second factor. And then solve for x. So here we will be having x equals positive 6. And here x is negative 4. So going back to the equation. So magkakaroon tayo ng restriction. X cannot be equal to negative 6. Because if x is negative 6, so magkakaroon tayo dito ng undefined. Okay, this term will be undefined. So, hindi pwedeng maging negative 6 ang x. But since wala naman tayo nakuhang value ng x na negative 6, so there's no problem. There's no extraneous solution. So, the values of x that we got are positive 6 and negative 4. And x in the problem, going back to the problem, x represents the number of or the amount of time it takes for the first machine to work alone. So we are talking about time. So time cannot be negative. Hindi tayo pwedeng magkaroon ng negative 4 time. So hindi natin pwedeng kunin ang negative 4 as the value of x. So we will be taking x equals 6. Alright? So going back to the problem. So the question is, how long would it take each machine to stuff a batch of envelopes by themselves? So if the first machine is represented by x, so and the value of x is 6, so therefore the first machine or machine number 1 is or will take 6 hours to do the work alone, and machine number 2 will take, so since machine number 2 is x plus 6 and x is 6, substitute that here. So we're gonna have 6 plus 6, so that's equivalent to 12. So machine number 2 will take 12 hours to work alone. So this is now, so these are now our answers. So machine number 1 is 6 hours and machine number 2 is 12 hours. So that will be all for today. I hope that you learned a lot from this video. So see you again in my next video. Goodbye.